Make your social media accounts almost bulletproof. With the recent iCloud security scandal dominating the headlines, now more than ever, it's important to revisit the issues of social media security. Your social media accounts contain an awful lot of information about you that cybercriminals can make use of, so it's essential that you make sure they're as unhackable as possible. Here are our 6 top tips to keep the bad guys out. Passwords. Although this may seem obvious, you'd be surprised at how many people use basic, insecure passwords for their social media accounts. Half of us use the same password on multiple accounts, and whether that's a sequential series of numbers, using the word password, or just easily discoverable things like the name of your dog or your favorite football team, you're leaving yourself wide open to online abuse. Use a mix of different characters, numbers, letters, and special characters to stay better protected. The more complex the combination, the harder it will be to crack. And make your password long. Think of it as a passphrase rather than a password, but use a phrase that you're going to remember. Storing passwords can be a headache too. So rather than writing them all down or storing them in one document on your computer, use a reputable cloud-based password manager such as Dashlane or LastPass to help stay on top of everything. Or better still, use an offline one for extra security like Schneier's Password Safe. Devices. Be aware that if you've set your device as a trusted device, anyone who gets their hands on your device can access your private information. Set a passcode so that only you have access to your device, and make it stronger than the default 4-character one, which are easy to crack with automated software. Again, a complex passphrase is your friend here. And if you lose your device or it happens to get stolen, if you've turned on remote wiping or tracking via Find My iPhone or Android Device Manager, even if you don't recover it, you can still erase all that sensitive information remotely. Third-party apps. Most, if not all, social media accounts are linked up to third-party apps, which is completely fine most of the time, but it is important to be aware that these apps can also be hacked and expose your account. So be sure to delete the links from your account to third-party apps you rarely or never use. You can always relink to them in the future should you need to. Phishing. Avoid clicking unidentified links that you receive in messages or emails from untrusted sources. And be sure to check the URL before entering sensitive information, or use Google to find the legitimate site before you enter your details. Two-factor authentication. Two-factor authentication adds an extra step to the security process. It works by using a secondary security measure, such as an app on your phone, to authenticate whether the person logging in is you. You enter your password and then enter a code generated by the app, making it much harder for cybercriminals to gain access to your account. To do this on Facebook, go to the Settings menu, select the security tag, and then click Login Approvals. For Twitter, simply go to the Security and Privacy section of your settings and click Login Verification. And for Google+, you click your picture in the top right of the screen, select Account, then Security, and then click the information icon. Click Two-Step Verification to enable it on your account. Lie. A little. And finally, stop thinking that you always need to be truthful when a site asks you to set security questions as a way back into your account if you ever forget your password. Lying will keep you safer, given the amount of personal information about you that exists online. So there's no need to tell a site your mother's real maiden name. Just make sure you remember your lie in case you ever need to regain access to your account. Or you could use that password manager we mentioned earlier to remember it for you. So that's it for our social media account security tips. For the latest news and views on internet security, head over to welivesecurity.com.